Oh, there's one. Yeah, we're talking about you, Governor. You think that Clifford, the red dog, is indoctrinating kids. Okay. Now imagine if you're thrown this in your improv special on Saturday night. What if he's there? Huh?
Can we
What if
just
he's
stop
there?
electing idiots? Can we stop electing tiny-brained idiots? He won't be there. He wouldn't be able to figure out how to use Zoom. I mean, these people that are our leaders are just moronic in every way. He
Yeah.
thinks a, please share the details, but he thinks a cartoon dog on PBS is indoctrinating people. Sharon, take it away.
Well, there it is. And that is our headline as we give you more details supporting that thesis, I guess. Oklahoma governor. He's a governor. Wow. Kevin Stitt exemplifies how the GOP are focusing on real pressing matters of national security, such as PBS and Clifford the Big Red Dog. Look at the eyes on that puppy. Why are you attacking Clifford? Last week, Governor Kevin Stitt vetoed a bill that authorized funding the Oklahoma Educational Television Authority, which broadcasts PBS programming through July 2026. Republicans have targeted PBS funding for years, including Donald Trump during his presidency and Mitt Romney as a presidential candidate in 2012. Mitt Romney's doing this too? Shame. Governor Stitt says, why? I don't think Oklahomans want to use their tax dollars to indoctrinate kids, Stitt told reporters on Friday about his decision to veto the bill. Some of the stuff that they're showing just overly sexualizes our kids. What does he mean by this? It's getting creepy. This is getting creepy. Well, here it is. After Stitt's vague allegations, his team continued the odd crusade. Spokeswoman also shared information indicating that two animated children's cartoons, Clifford the Big Red Dog and Work It Out Wombats. I've not seen that one. Work It Out Wombats, both airing on PBS affiliates, have included, lesbian characters in some episodes. Now we're getting to the heart of this thing. Other shows on the network have their funding targeted as well. Here are just some of the culprits deemed responsible for brainwashing. Elmo, oh, not Mr. Rogers, you done took it too far. And Bob Ross, look at the lineup there. Mugshots? If this governor gets sway. Jahan Jones, founder of the Black Obituary Project, a writer for MSNBC, reported on the whole fiasco. Here he is. Jones added some much-needed sensibility to the matter, writing, first of all, if you watch Clifford the Big Red Dog or Work It Out Wombats and think, gee, there's an awful lot of sexiness going on here, that sounds like a personal issue. But fundamentally, Stitt's veto is nothing more than anti-LGBTQ government censorship. It feels like, and yeah, your point's well taken, Ben. Stop electing, I think you said the word was idiots. But at the same time, this is a coordinated distraction, is it not? To keep us from paying attention to, oh yeah, we have less and less, and we can't make rent this month.
It's a strong point, a strong point, and I would like to maybe correct my previous statement. Let's stop electing evil people, malintentioned people who are manipulating the idiots in the populace, because you're right, they know what they're doing. These leaders know that Clifford, the big red dog, is not sexualizing children, but millions of people that vote for these people don't understand that. They don't realize that, no, the cartoon dog is not the issue. It's the issues that you're allowing to be the issue that are distracting from what really matters in this country. I mean, look at the horror that they're alleging. Clifford had lesbian characters sometimes. The cartoon didn't have the lesbian characters doing gay things in the cartoon. There weren't graphic scenes. They're lesbian characters just being people.
Yeah.
Being people who exist, because guess what? Whether you are comfortable with gay people or not, they certainly exist. And nothing that you believe in your twisted head means that they don't get equal rights or equal treatment or equal exposure in media so that their presence can be more normalized in your bigoted heads. You can hate if you want to. You can hate in the privacy of your own home and have twisted ideas. There's no way we could ever make that illegal. But we certainly can stand up fervently and very forcefully against your idiotic, twisted, bigoted mindset from infiltrating one inch of the public sphere. And when that happens, you're done.
Yeah. The clarity is everything, and it's well taken. And I think we need to remind people, and we can put up Clifford again. Those eyes are adorable, but let's remember Clifford, born and growing out of a young girl's love for a tiny puppy. The dog grew literally because she loved it so much. That's the moral of this story. It's just about love and friendship. They became best friends. How is that indoctrination unless you don't want people to love and you don't want people to be friends? I'll give you the last word.
Yeah, that's a very good point. They are anti anything that softens people's heart. So I think that's part of the issue there. Two last thoughts. Anybody who thinks that PBS is too sexy really has got to go out to a nightclub and get your dance on or something. You got to get a new wardrobe and try to up the sexiness in your own private life, because it's the least sexy channel in the history of humanity. And everybody that has ever enjoyed any sexy experience in their life obviously knows that. And secondly, to prove yet again, not that we need more proof, but just for good measure, to show how disingenuous this opinion of the governor and all who are anti-PBS funding are, he said the sentence, "We think these PBS shows are overly sexualizing our children." Implicit in that sentence, he thinks there's a certain amount of sexualizing our children that is okay. Just don't overdo it.
Yeah, I heard it too. And you know what's sad? We've lost our ability to think for ourselves, and this groupthink has taken over. Because you're right, there's nothing going on in the Clifford show or Wombats. Have you watched this Wombats?
No, that one I am afraid is going to make me gay.
Okay. Well, we'll have to see, because there's going to be tons of people who are running and turning on PBS. They might get biggest ratings ever to see if this thing is all sexed up. They're going to do that.